Excuse me. What in the world are you thinking?
Mean Gene, the first thing you need to do is to tell these people to shut up if you want to hear what I got to say.
What up, y'all? It's KMB, the Sexy Ninja, and the place to be for a Paper Saber Universe. Welcome to the New World Podcast, brother. We're going to talk about NXT July 4th, 2023. Vic Joseph, Booker T on commentary. We start the show off with Roxanne Perez versus Blair Davenport. Blair Davenport for the win. This was a good match. This is a good way to start the show. A lot of good stuff going on tonight with this NXT. So Ivy Nile's backstage interview. She's interrupted by Tiffany Stratton. They got a match next week. Biggest part about this was Baron Corbin's package. Burn it all. Said, you know, I tried to bring the lone wolf, and I don't want gimmicks. I don't want this. Took his crown, and he threw it in the fire, and he burned it all, and says, it's time. No more bullshit. It's time to be Baron Corbin. I'm like, okay, I like this. Rescrub. This is the rescrub that we've been waiting for Baron Corbin, and I hope he makes the most of it. Mustafa Ali versus Tyler Bate. Great matches all set up from last week because, you know, Mustafa Ali was a referee with Tyler Bate and Wesley. But after Mustafa Ali got the win over Tyler Bate, he goes on and challenges Wesley at the Great American Bash for his championship, the North American Championship. And I was like, oh, okay. And I got to say, everything Mustafa Ali's been doing here, I've been enjoying a lot more than what he was doing on the main roster. So, and then we have Joe Gacy and Ava backstage interview talking about the big match, the Creed Brothers versus the Dyad, the loser leaves NXT. Joe saying, like, the better team will win, the real team will win. And she was interviewing, like, what does that mean? He's like, you'll see. Don't worry. Kalani, Jordan, Verdana Brooke versus Tatum Paxley. Jordan for the win. Impressive debut, I will say. She looked great in that ring. She brought it to Paxley, but I'm really happy about her feud going into with Cora Jade, because Cora Jade comes out and, you know, they're like, yeah, and Jordan's like, you got some, come get some, you know. So we're setting up a story there between those two. Chase U backstage is dumb as I don't like Chase U whatsoever. This was pretty entertaining just because Duke had to yell at a student class, you know, Chase is back and everything, but it's still silly. But this right here, I was like, it could go one way or the other. NXT Underground, Eddie Thorpe versus Damon Kemp. And they took a silly concept and made it awesome. Oh my gosh, I did not expect this to be this good. NXT Underground must be a thing going forward. You know, especially in the setting, I was like, oh, it's supposed to be backstage and underground. But I like the fact that I like what they did. I like the setup in the ring and everything like that. But this was awesome. I mean, like, it was electric. There was some crazy spots where Eddie was thrown out of the ring and stuff like that. This was just a real... I was surprised as everybody else. I was looking on Twitter and everyone was like, holy shit, you know. Then Gable comes in. Stevenson, the Olympic gold medalist, and he gets some, like, after Eddie Thorpe just starts throwing motherfuckers around, like, ah, ah, yeah. Everyone's hyped, man. Then up next, we had Carmelo and Trick. They call out the Judgment Day, tell them to show up next week. So I was like, ooh, okay. D'Angelo is still in jail, quotation mark. Stax comes and visits him, brings Joe coffee. They made a deal. It all comes down to a match because that's how the legal system works in Florida. It comes down to a match. And if Stax beats Joe, D'Angelo is free. If not, he goes to trial. Freedom or trial next week between Joe Coffey and Stax. It's going to be crazy. And Stax was mad. Not Stax. D'Angelo was mad because Stax went into business for himself and made this deal himself. So he kicked the shit out of that phone right afterwards. Some Von Wagner crap happened. Don't care. Noam Dar losing his mind, talking to pictures of his NXT Heritage Cup. Don't care. But this right here. Oh, wait. Kiana James' office was violated by Gigi. Don't care. Now, let's get to the loser leaves NXT. The Dyad for the win. But somebody helped. Who is it? A masked mystery person. But as I've been saying, the Creed brothers need to move up. They're awesome. They're just such a great tag team, and I think they would add really, they would do really, really well on the main roster. They've been doing this for so long on NXT, and I'm really glad to see what they're going to do up on the main roster after this. So much love and much respect to the Creed brothers. Where does that leave Ivy? Well, she has a match next week against good old women's NXT champion Tiffany Stratton. We'll see how that goes. Finn Balor answers and says he will show up next week. He will show up to Carmelo and get face-to-face, or they'll have a match. We'll see what happens. But I like the fact that we're doing some main roster stuff, and especially with the Judgment Day, because they're taking over slowly everything. Bron Breakker comes out, cuts a promo, says, blah, 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 I'm Bron Breakker. But the best part happened. Ilya Dragunov came out and says, I'm next. And he and Ilya does not waste or hesitate any way whatsoever. He goes right after Bron Breakker, like a G, like Ilya Dragunov is, and just takes, like, it just ends in a big fight. Great show. I honestly will give this a 4 out of 5. I had a good time, man, and I'm excited to see Bron Breakker and Ilya Dragunov, because I'm rooting for Ilya Dragunov just to whoop that ass. All right, y'all, tell me what you thought of the show. Drop those comments below. Tell me what you thought of NXT this week, you know, for the July 4th edition. Vic Joseph, Booker T on commentary, in the bag. Swish, K&B, don't miss. All right, like and subscribe. Share it with your grandma, share it with your grandma. Share the bum down at Walmart. I am K&B, the sexy ninja. And as always, the New World Podcast is for life, brother.
Throw that long haul, get that deep water.
Big right hook from Champion. Talking about putting together a camp for Thorpe.